Welcome to this presentation where we're going to talk about using the HPE CSI driver for Kubernetes with HPE Nimble Storage. My name is Michael Madsen. I'm a tech marketing engineer with Hewlett Packard Enterprise. Before we dive into the demo, I'm just going to walk through a PowerPoint slide here and talk a little bit about HPE Nimble Storage, which is the reference implementation for the HPE CSI driver for Kubernetes. HPE Nimble Storage is a block storage array that does iSCSI and fiber channel out the front, and then it supports a number of different enterprise data management capabilities such as compression, encryption. You can do snapshots, you can clone snapshots. It has a concept of setting a protection template to do automatic snapshots, performance policies, QoS limits, you name it, right? You access these capabilities through a REST API and through the data paths, either iSCSI or fiber channel. And to access the capabilities through Kubernetes, you need to deploy the HPE CSI driver for Kubernetes with the HPE Nimble Storage container storage provider. And then you will then get access to all these API objects in Kubernetes, like a storage class. You can create volume snapshots through volume snapshot classes. Users can create persistent volume claims, and so forth, right? And we differentiate ourselves by allowing different parameters in the storage class, right, that reference these capabilities that you can see at the bottom, right? So you can specify which access protocol you want to use. We have this feature called allow overrides, which allows the user to annotate his persistent volume claims with different tweaks that he wants to do with his storage, right? And I'm going to illustrate how that actually works in practice. And we also have the ability to throttle the IOPS and performance, the throughput, and specify custom placements on the array itself. And I'm going to show you how that works as well. So let's dive into the demo. In this demo, I have a Kubernetes cluster set up. I have the HPE CSI driver installed. I have my HPE Nimble Storage backend configured. And what I'm going to do here, I'm just going to walk through the admin interface on the Nimble array, how to set up a few different objects here that we can leverage from Kubernetes. So go to manage data storage, and I want to set up a custom folder where I want to store all my Kubernetes volumes, right? So I'm just going to give it a name, Kubernetes. This is my Kubernetes folder. And I want to put a limit on how much space it can consume. I want to do a I want to confine the performance to 10,000 IOPS. There we go. Next, I'm going to go into data protection and set up a custom protection template. The template is actually already set up. It's called Local 48 in Cloud 96, and it's currently being replicated to HPE Cloud Volumes. So I can protect my data in the cloud and being able to recover from the cloud in the event of a disaster. There's also a data access tab, but since the HPE CSI driver for Kubernetes sets up all the initiators and such for you, you don't really have to go into any specific details there. I'm also going to create a custom performance policy. Since we're going to deploy Jenkins in my example, I'm just going to give it a name, Jenkins, and make sure that volumes get deduped and compressed and so forth. There we go. Before we drop to kubectl, there are a few things I want to show you here. So we have this documentation portal. It's called HPE Storage Container Orchestrated Documentation. We call it SCOD. And there you can find all the parameters that are relevant for HPE Nimble Storage, right? So if you go to the container storage provider and you go to the storage class parameters within there, you will see that we've divided the parameters into different sections, like the common parameters, the provisioning parameters, and how to use pod inline volumes, cloning, importing, and volume snapshots classes. And these tables describe all the different parameters that we support for the different operations, right? So we don't have enough time in this demo to go through all the different parameters. So I'm just going to show you at a glance what you can do with these very powerful constructs. Switching over to my terminal here, I'm just going to see if there's any storage classes created. There's not. So I'm going to create a new one. And I'm using the base storage class that you can find on our documentation portal. And then I'm going to add a few specific Nimble tweaks, right? So what I want to be able to do is make sure that I have array delete protection on my volumes. I want to make sure that once I detach a volume, the destination gets updated. I want to leverage my custom protection templates. I want to drop all my volumes in the Kubernetes folder I just created. And then I want to be able to allow users that create persistent volume claims to annotate their PVCs, to use a custom performance policy, custom description. And I also want to allow them to import offline volumes. And I'm going to show you why that is relevant later. All right, I'm going to create the storage class. Next, I'm going to create a custom PVC. And I mentioned I'm going to deploy Jenkins, right? So I'm just going to annotate my PVC. I'm going to give it a custom description, my custom Jenkins claim. And I'm also going to leverage the performance policy that we just created, which is named Jenkins. And I'm going to give it a size, 100 gig, and it's going to be a read-write once volume. I'm going to go ahead and create that. The PVC got created. I'm also going to use Helm to deploy Jenkins. And I'm also going to make sure that the PVC we manually created actually gets used by Jenkins. So my values file contains persistence, existing claim, my Jenkins PVC, and we're going to make sure that that gets picked up when we deploy Jenkins. Just going to do a Helm install, reference my values file, give it a name, I'm going to pull the latest table. There we go. It takes a while for Jenkins to come up, so we're going to fast forward here a little bit. All right, it's up. Switching over to my array here and go under the data storage tab, I can now see that I have indeed a PVC created in my Kubernetes folder. And we can also see my custom description set there on the volume, my custom Jenkins claim. I can also see that I'm leveraging my Jenkins performance policy. And we can also see that the volume is protected in a volume collection through the replication partner I named Cloud Workloads, which is a replication destination in HPE Cloud Volumes. Next, I'm going to show you how to use the array-based delete protection. And I'm going to delete the persistent volume claim that we created. Switching back to my array, we can see that the volume still exists. It has been offline because it's no longer in use. Well, what you can do here is simply copy the volume name, and I have a import.yaml persistent volume claim here where I annotate my PVC and I say import volume name, and I'll simply paste the Nimble volume name into that field, and I will then be able to get the volume back into my Kubernetes cluster again, right? Switching back to my array, we can see that the volume is now online. The name has changed to match the new PV name. So going back to my Kubernetes cluster, we can see that this actually matches what we have. And that's basically how you would recover from an accidental deletion from your Kubernetes cluster. What has happened in the background here while we've been experimenting with this demonstration is that the volume has been replicated to HPE Cloud Volumes during this time. So switching over to my web browser here, visiting cloudvolumes.hpe.com and log into the HPE Cloud Volumes portal, I can see under my replica volumes that I actually have a volume replicated. And as we inspect that, we can see that that is indeed the persistent volume claim that I created. It's my 100 gig volume with the Jenkins performance policy from my on-premises Nimble array. And that's all I had for today. If you enjoyed this content and would like to know more, please visit hpe.com/storage/containers. Until next time, take care.